Cellular metabolism can in many ways be thought of as a series of linked enzymatic pathways. In other words, a series of chemical reactions catalyzed by enzymes. And in many cases, those metabolic pathways have to be regulated. These are pathways that include the production and use of cellular energy, for instance. To do so, we can regulate enzyme function in three separate ways here. First, we can alter enzyme expression. In other words, we could literally alter the transcription and translation of particular enzymes to either up or down regulate the activity of that particular pathway. In the second one, we can alter enzyme activity. In this case, we're altering the functionality of an enzyme that's already been produced. This is often done chemically through alterations to the protein structure. One common mechanism there is adding and removing phosphate groups, turning the enzyme on or off. The last one shown here is to alter enzyme affinity, and that's where we're going to focus right now. In that case, the enzyme is there, it's active, but what we're going to do is we're going to change its activity level by adjusting the enzyme affinity. So if we look over here in A, we're going to look at what's called allosteric modulation. An allosteric modulation is when you have a regulatory molecule bind the protein, the enzyme, at a non-active site location, yet that alters how the enzyme functions. So let's take a close look here. The enzyme is the circle. The active site is shown here, and a substrate would come in and bind, right, to be catalyzed, the reaction to be catalyzed. So in this particular enzyme, we have an allosteric site that binds this allosteric modulator. And what happens is it changes the shape, the conformation of the protein, in this case, such that it modifies the shape to make the active site less likely to bind the substrate, right? We've distorted the active site. In that case, we're actually inhibiting the enzyme by reducing its affinity for the substrate. In the opposite scenario over here in B, the active site starts out as a little bit distorted, and we would have a relatively low affinity and low activity. In this case, binding of the allosteric modulator to its site, again, changes the protein structure, but in this scenario, provides an active site that is more likely to bind the substrate and process it, increasing its output over time.